Welcome to the first class of Mathematics 1. My name is Professor Arnoud van Messem and I will be teaching mathematics to you this semester. The exercises will be provided by the TAs. Depending on your group, you will have to contact a different TA if you have questions or you want some extra feedback. Group 1 will consist of all the new enrollers. The repeaters are divided over groups 2 and 3. For group 1, the TA is Mena Marcos. Group 2, it will be Nathan Muyinda, and group 3, Nikin Harandi. As you know, mathematics is a year-long course, so it means that the entire course is spread over the entire year. So you will have Mathematics 1 in the first semester, which is taught by me, as well as Mathematics 1 in the second semester, which will be taught by Professor Rao. Due to the special circumstances, we now start with online teaching. Theory lectures will be given on Mondays and on Wednesdays. On Friday, the exercise session takes place. For the lectures, you will receive lecture videos, so like this one, a video where I will be explaining the theory. The goal is that you follow the lectures, that you attentively follow the lectures and also take notes of what I am telling you. It's very important to take notes because it will help you process the information. Due to the online teaching, a lot of it will also be in self-study. So you will have this, you will have these lectures, you will have these videos, but you will have to work yourself to understand what's in it. And also several Q&A sessions will be organized where you can come to me with your questions. Next to that, you will also have exercise sessions. After the Wednesday lecture, you will receive a set of exercises. The goal is that you try to solve these exercises yourself. By solving them, you will practice and you will see if you understand the theory. Next to the questions themselves, you will also get hints, both written and some videos with hints. So it's very important that you actively try to solve the exercises. The more questions you try to solve, the more practice you will get, the more prepared you will be for the exam. After the weekend, you will then also receive the final answers. So these will also be posted online, but they are really the final answers, they are not the solutions. So we will not provide you an entirely worked out solution. The goal is that you try to solve them yourself. And then if something is blocking you, if you cannot go on, then you can go to a TA and ask for extra feedback. Next to the basic exercises, we will also provide sets of extra problems. These sets of extra problems give you the possibility to practice even more. They will not be solved during class, and we will also not solve them for you. If you have for these a very specific question, of course, you can contact the TA and they will help you. All communication will be done through Euphora. Therefore, it is important that you regularly check the course site on Euphora and keep up to date with the content. All exercises and all lectures will be posted online on Euphora. It is also a very good idea to set up the setting in Euphora so that if an announcement is made, you receive this announcement via email. What will we be seeing this year? So the course content for this semester is trigonometry. So we will look at angles, we will see identities, trigonometric formulas, equations. What are the properties in triangles? So what can we say about the sides and the angles of a triangle? We will solve height and distance problems and we will take a look at inverse trigonometric functions. After trigonometry, we will go to coordinate geometry. So we'll just do it very simple in two dimensions. And we will look at lines and circles and problems related to those. The next part is limits and continuity. After that, we will see derivatives, so differential calculus. Then there's an intermezzo of algebra, where we will discuss complex numbers, polynomials, binomial theorem, and also proof techniques. And now we will end with integrals. And finally, some words on the examination. So your final mark will be based on the marks for your term 1 examination and your term 2 examination. So when you have the examination in June, you will get a part on the first semester in the morning, which counts for 50% of the total mark, and in the afternoon you get a second exam on term 2, which counts also for 50%. Different from previous years, full marks will for now be given on the examination and there will be no testing. Due to the corona situation, everything is online, so it's very difficult to hold tests, and so full marks are on the examination. How does it happen in practice? So in practice, you will get a partial examination in December. So it means you get an examination on the topics of the first semester in December. And this is actually an extra opportunity to gain your marks. So if you succeed in December, you have an exemption for the first part in June. In June, you then have the final examination, which is, as I said, about both term one and term two. And if you scored at least 10 out of 20 for your partial examination, you get an exemption for that one, and you only have to take the second part of the exam. If you should fail, don't worry, there is still a third option to succeed the course, which is in August. So recent examinations happen in August, and the recent examination is also again on term one and term two topics. So there are no partial exemptions for the recent, which means that even if you succeeded in December, you will have to redo the examination on term one.